Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. It is I, NoDQ.com, one and only, King Virtue. And I have a few topics I would like to discuss with you this evening. No, I am not the Macho King. I am not King Kong Bundy, nor am I King Harley Race, or King Mabel, or Jerry the King Lawler. I'm not even the King of Kings. I'm not King Booker. I'm not the King of the Ring. I'm definitely not King or Prince Hades. No, I'm none of those. I am King Virtue, one of the main attractions of NoDQ.com. I'd like to call myself the main attraction, but it's a team, so I'm one of many main attractions. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about everything. Obviously, we're going to talk about wrestling. Some Eric Bischoff, some Survivor Series, and some Big Vito and feedback from the NoDQ Pop panel. I also will announce the winner of Rhyme for Xbox One. And I will also give you my video game and movie, I guess we'll call it what, of the week. So, with that said, I will try to see questions. I have to keep my shades on, you know, because it took a lot of candles to light this up. And quite honestly, here in medieval times, it's usually pretty dark. So when there's a lot of light, it strains my eyes, hence the shades indoors. So I hope you guys don't mind, and gals. Let's see, before I kick off, looking good as the King. Well, thank you, Brandon King. I like your last name. As a matter of fact, you know what? You were the random drawing winner for the video game, Brandon King. And what I ended up doing is there was a lot of different names from my tweets from the Great Lakes video game page. If you gave multiple comments, you got multiple names in the hat. So that helped you, Brandon King. So private message me your address, and I will send you this copy of Rhyme. If you want Virtue to sign it, I will. If not, no biggie. Now, with that said, I know everyone wants to hear wrestling. This is the next giveaway on my Great Lakes video game page. It's a exclusive to Best Buy Link Majora's Mask Amiibo. Now, sorry, Brandon, you will be ineligible to win this since you won the game. But I suggest anyone that wants to try to win this, multiple comments or tweets about video games will help your chances. So congratulations, Mr. King. And I swear that I did not do that because of this. That was actually what happened. And when I picked your name, that inspired me to do this Virtue's Rage dressed as a king. So I hope you guys like it. UXWA, 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 get the word out. I think I just did. So with that said, I see viewers coming and going. They might not be digging this king gimmick, but quite honestly, look, I don't have a scepter, but I do have this hardcore championship belt of the FOW right here. And that is still Virtue's. King Virtue is still the FOW, Future of Wrestling, hardcore champion. And one day, I will defend this against somebody. But that's my scepter, okay? That's my scepter. So let's see what we have. I know SmackDown's coming on at 8, so it's already 7:20 Eastern time. So we'll get this done and out of the way before SmackDown so everybody can enjoy SmackDown. That's the wrong cue card. Eric Bischoff. Look, I Googled the net worth of Eric Bischoff earlier today, and it's between $10 and $12 million, right? Eric Bischoff is a millionaire. he should not be suckholing money from indie wrestling feds. Now, you've seen on Twitter, you might have heard on some dirt sheets, a big announcement coming from Eric Bischoff. You know, is Hulk Hogan and Eric Bischoff going to be on Monday Night Raw, 25th anniversary coming up in January? An indie fed was actually acting like that was the big announcement in Cleveland, whatever their name is. Like Eric Bischoff was co-owner. Look, we all know it's a one-time appearance. Somebody worth $10 to $12 million, like Eric Bischoff, that ran WCW, that was the general manager of Raw on Monday Night Raw for WWE, that was in TNA, they're not going to go lower than that. Unless he did something like Billy Corgan and owned like an NWA or bought TNA, right? That would be the only thing Eric Bischoff would do. You pay him as an appearance for your indie show, that's all it is, okay? Fans are smart. Don't play stupid. Just say he's there for an appearance. Don't act like he's a co-owner, okay? And on top of that, what has Eric Bischoff really done for the wrestling industry? Now, I'm going to give him credit. He helped put WCW ahead of Monday Night Raw, WWF, in the ratings. But how did that happen? Did he maybe steal a concept of a faction like the NWO from Japan back in the 90s? Did maybe he have Ted Turner's open checkbook? Perhaps a lot of disgruntled wrestlers that left the WWF wanting more money, and he was giving them guaranteed contracts from Ted Turner's wallet? I wonder if that was the reason WCW succeeded. You know, I'll give Eric credit. NWO was pretty solid. It drew mainstream audience, you know what I mean? But also, let's face it, Eric didn't know how to manage a wrestling company, because as great as WCW was while it was ahead of WWE, or F at the time, Eric Bischoff ran it in the ground. And everyone's going to say, oh, it was a Time Warner and AOL merger. The nail was already in the coffin, okay? Eric Bischoff overspent, put too many egos in one locker room, and that was it. You know, and everybody can say Vince Russo killed WCW or the AOL Time Warner merger, whatever. But I want to say, as good as Eric Bischoff was at getting WCW ahead of WWF, he also killed it. He's a talented guy when it comes to an on-screen character. I'll give him that. He's a good cocky prick. And my name ain't Brad Maddox. Eric Bischoff can play a good heel authority figure on screen. That's what he's at his best. But running a wrestling company, absolutely not. Or partaking and contributing to creative control of a wrestling company, how did that go, TNA? Is Bischoff and Hogan going to land somewhere else and suck all the money out of them and put them into oblivion and send them up to Canada? So, you know, when it comes down to it, indie wrestling, don't use a guy like Eric Bischoff and pay him $3,000 for an appearance unless he's going to come to do it and collect his own money from his own merch. You know, I could see you giving that guy maybe $200, right? $250 tops to show up. But, I mean, I just don't get it. When you have younger generations of people out there that have their new following that will bring indie fans. I mean, what's Bischoff going to bring all the NWO fans from the 90s and all the casuals to your indie wrestling show? And when I hear this word sold out, an indie wrestling show is never sold out, okay? It's never sold out. Maybe a couple times AIW and Johnny Gargano's farewell before he went to NXT, because, you know, some fire marshals say you can only fit so many people in a building. If that's the case, then you're sold out. But don't say you're sold out, okay? And Eric Bischoff, NWO sold out, you know, whatever. But here's the thing. If Bischoff ever does anything big in wrestling again, it's going to be these one-off appearances with WWE, like the Table for Three, introducing somebody, you know, or doing a speech at the Hall of Fame ceremony, maybe a short-term authority figure on one of the shows, or coming out and running a stable. I get that, right? That would be okay, you know, because Eric Bischoff, again, you don't need to be suckholding money out of small indie feds. And what I'm thinking is, unless you're like an NWA with Billy Corgan at the helm, TNA with Anthem at the helm, Ring of Honor, New Japan,
I won't even say Lucha Underground, but if you're one of those with TV time, with somebody that's got some, you know, hundreds of thousands of millions of dollars backing you, then you bring in Eric Bischoff. Right? That's exactly what you do. Or is it none of those people want Eric, so he's settling for indie wrestling? But nonetheless, moving on. Anyway, let me look. Anybody's thoughts on Eric Bischoff? I see Certified G is here. Well, thank you for joining. I didn't really see any questions about Eric. If you did ask them, then I missed them. So my apologies. Because they scroll up. So if I missed your question, feel free to retype it, and I will try to answer it. Survivor Series. Oh. Bragging rights. You know, whatever we want to call it. There's some things that are sticking out like a sore thumb. So, yay, good for Roman coming back and Bray. Although I think Bray, other than him, who did he attack? Jason Jordan. So he did get a little bit of his heat back for letting Jason Jordan do a roll-up pin on him at Raw. But, I mean, come on, Bray. I feel so bad for Bray. He really needs a break the fourth wall. I've talked about this before, but he just needs to come out. And he can still say he's Bray Wyatt, but he needs to ditch the gimmick and talk from the heart like CM Punk style. I think a lot of people would get behind Bray Wyatt if he did that.
Family Guy is here. Man, Matt King joined. Jeff said, Jeff H., Eric Bischoff needs to be done. You know, and a lot of people will say that about Vince Russo too. But, I mean, what's Vince Russo doing? Is he trying to get back in the wrestling business? People will say, oh, he's sending letters to Vince McMahon and he's trying to get back into WWF. No, he's doing his podcasting. He's on Podcast One. You know, I'm sure he's having fun doing that, staying at home, sitting on his bank. You know, he's back out in Colorado working with indie feds like Rocky Mountain Pro. Creatively, though, because they were going to be on TV and that TV deal kind of fell through with some shenanigans. But Vince was writing their television shows or their YouTube shows. That's cool. I like that. Vince is a creative guy. He's not there trying to – I don't think he was getting paid too much money to do that, whereas Bischoff would probably demand, like, ransom. So – but back to Survivor Series. What sticks out like a sore thumb to me is – now, the New Day versus the Shield, Roman's back, okay. But really, I mean, are we thinking the New Day is at the level of the Shield? So, I mean, really – so they had to have the Shield beat up the Bar and the Miz. But how does that make New Day? I know they had a long tag team run, title run, and they held the belts for a while, a couple different times. But, I mean, let's call a spade a king of spade, a king of spade, okay? The New Day, in my opinion, is not credible enough to be facing the Shield. You bring the Shield back together as a reunion to sell T-shirts, to create excitement. I mean, you can kind of see Seth Rollins and Ambrose are pretty excited because they were kind of like flatlining a little bit. You know, Roman was always pushed up there. But you see they're excited about this angle. But what you need to do is put them against somebody that could beat them. And in my opinion, the New Day can't, unless it was like 5-on-3. So I like the New Day, but they're just like a cartoony gimmick against the Shield. To me, it does not work. And the Shield should run over them. And you know what? I always want to give my T-shirts away if I'm wrong. I was contemplating on – I'm going to ask you guys real quick, and you put in the comments, should I make my T-shirt bet that I do like on Twitter where I pick the winner of Brock Lesnar and AJ Styles, or should I pick the winner of the Shield versus the New Day? Anybody have any input on that? Because I will tell you, whatever match it is, I will pick my winner. All you have to do is go to my Twitter when I announce put that up there in the next few days, and you retweet it and or like it. And everybody that does that, your Twitter handle gets put into a hat. And if I'm wrong, I have to be 100% wrong on my pick, I randomly will pick one of those people, and they will get, now that they're on ProWrestlingTees.com, a Virtues Rage upside down NoDQ.com T-shirt. So you will get that if I'm wrong. Somebody says Lesnar versus Styles. Anybody want me to pick? I think you don't want me to pick New Day versus Shield because it's too obvious that I'll pick the Shield and none of you will have a chance to win. So you know what? As much as I like picking Roman, Roman's always been my, you know, I'm like 4-0 doing this. I will go ahead and make the Brock versus AJ match, the tweet that I will put up. And if I'm wrong on calling it,
the winner, one random person that retweets and or likes that tweet will win a Virtues Rage NoDQ.com t-shirt.
I'm going to go with, you knew it, Brock Lesnar. Now, with that said, don't panic because you lose nothing for liking or retweeting the tweet when I put it up. All you have to do now is you're gonna have emotion now into AJ Styles because I'm going Brock Lesnar is going to win the match. He is going to win the match against AJ. F5, it doesn't matter how he wins it. He's going to win the match. But if I'm wrong and AJ beats Brock, if it does happen, if AJ beats Brock, guess what? Somebody wins a t-shirt. Now, if they change that match tonight on SmackDown and add like gender and make it a triple threat, which they won't, I'm still going that match and Brock goes over the match. But right now, let's not think negatively like that, and it's going to be Brock versus AJ. I pick Brock. Everybody will like that tweet when I post it and retweet it. If you retweet it, you get a double shot. Your name goes in twice. Better chance to win. And I'm going Brock, so you guys want AJ.
So with that said, I don't want to talk about anything else Survivor Series because we've done that, and I actually will give my panel video spot up if the timing works. I'll be on the video if I have to for the preview and predictions. But I want Big Vito LaGrasso to be on the prediction preview video. So if we have four people, and I'm one of them, I will remove myself. If Big Vito can make the Skype call with Aaron and the other people, then Big Vito can be on that panel video. What do you guys think? Do you want Big Vito on more NoDQ stuff? He does do work with Vince Russo and Vince Russo's brand, so you know that. He does his own stuff too. But he knows, he's not dumb. He knows that NoDQ has tons of Twitter followers, tons of YouTube subscribers, Facebook likes. So he's getting his name back out there remembered for the people that forgot. And some wrestling fans might not have remembered who he was. But if you want more Big Vito, let's see. Paul, if AJ beats Brock, I'll buy someone a whole new wardrobe. Hey, put that out there as a tweet. And if I missed your question, feel free to. Jeff said, yeah, Vito was good. Certified G needs to be on a prediction video. Well, you know how to reach Aaron.
Go ahead and do that.
But, yeah, that was one of my things I wanted to talk. If you want more of Big Vito on NoDQ, and he can plug all of his stuff, you know, I mean, obviously he sells T-shirts, and, you know, if he gets ad traffic on his website that he's about to create, we don't know. I mean, you know, Aaron Rift will attest NoDQ's on a low budget. So Vito isn't going to get paid. But will he get the recognition from the NoDQ Galaxy? Absolutely. So go ahead and tweet Big Vito, or you can see him on the, I think it's at the Big Vito brand. And then on Facebook, you know he's Big Vito LaGrasso, and he's actually in the NoDQ wrestling discussion page. So reach out to him and tag Aaron in it, because that'll make him show back up on NoDQ video a lot quicker. Back to Survivor Series, because you know me, I like to zigzag. Just like what, and I don't know where this is from, but just when I'm zigging, then I'm zagging. And not Dolph Ziggler either. By the way, where is Dolph Ziggler? Does anybody know where Dolph Ziggler is? Here's my problem with Survivor Series. And it's not all. There's John Cena on Team SmackDown. Triple H on Team Raw. Of course, Kurt Angle and Shane McMahon. Now, a lot of people will think all of those guys are has-beens. Put all the new people in there. Two of them, I agree that statement with. Two of them should be in the match. And that is Angle and Shane. You know, Shane can still go. He's a special attraction. But let's face it, Roman was sick. Wyatt was sick. They pushed these guys up there, and they got to go with them a little bit longer. So the fact that, again, both guys can be protected and only do, you know, certain spots in the match, I like it. I think Shane and Angle should be in the match, because them just being at ringside in a suit and tie would be boring. So I'm perfectly fine with the Raw general manager and the SmackDown. Is it commissioner? I get confused. I don't know who's commissioner. Maybe Shane is a general manager and then Daniel Bryan's commissioner of SmackDown. I don't know. It's confusing. But we know that's Kurt Angle and Shane. I like them being on those opposing teams. Now, what is invested in the match? What is this ending of a match result in? Nothing. And what it should result in is, in my opinion, whatever team wins, so if Team Raw wins, I think they should be able to pluck a talent from SmackDown. If Team SmackDown wins, they should be able to pluck a talent from Team Raw. But WWE has given us nothing. This match means absolutely nothing other than bragging rights. That's where we're at, seriously. But my problem is Triple H and John Cena. Seriously, those two don't need to be in this match. Now, does Jason Jordan? No, he doesn't need to be in the match either. You could have plugged Bray Wyatt in there, but whatever. John Cena is the biggest mystery of them all because he lost to Roman Reigns and did the whole I'm leaving for a while thing, and it was Raw. He was on Raw as a free agent. Now he's just randomly on Team SmackDown.
Does anybody have any thoughts? I know Jeff, I see Jeff agrees.
The John Cena, like, seriously, go away, John Cena. Go away. And if you're going to come back, have the proper build. If anything, Triple H should be removed from Team Raw. And if Cena came back and was on Team Raw because that's where he was last, okay, perfect, fine. And then maybe in some weird turn of events, Triple H would end up on Team SmackDown for whatever reason, you know. Here's the thing. You know what else would be cool? But now it's all out the window because Triple H is on Team Raw in the match. If that ended the show, and I'm assuming the 5-on-5 Survivor Series match will end the show, although they do have the Brock and AJ match. But if the 5-on-5 match ended the show, or whatever it is, 6-on-6, 7-on-7, 8-on-8, what would have been good is it comes down to a couple of guys on each team. Just when you think maybe Raw was going to win, SmackDown was holding on, survive, trying to survive, Triple H would have came out. This is assuming Triple H wouldn't have been in the match. He comes out, his music, everyone's like, what? And then out of the crowd or just out of nowhere, some of your top NXT guys, like a Nexus angle, hit the ring, beat everybody up, and it ends. And that's how the pay-per-view goes off. Like, what? Now, they can't do something like that, A, because it's too creative, B, why have developmental guys get over on the two major brands, and three, what are you going to do, send all those guys back to NXT because you can't strip NXT of its talent or NXT won't have anybody? What would have been good if you would have held Nakamura, Bobby Roode, whoever else came up in the past year, if you would have held them off of coming up to the main roster a little bit longer, that would have been perfect timing for them to come up to the main roster as Triple H's NXT brand. I mean, that, and then they could have stayed there representing NXT, but that would have been their move to the main roster. That would have been Survivor Series. That would have been like 1998, was it 1998 Survivor Series? Yeah, when The Rock, the corporation and the whole Shane McMahon against Austin and Mankind. That's when Survivor Series was good stuff, right? I was at the 1992 Survivor Series at Richfield Coliseum. That's when it was supposed to be Ultimate Warrior and the Macho Man versus Razor Ramon and Ric Flair. While Ultimate Warrior got the boot, was replaced by Mr. Perfect. That was a fun match. Razor and Ric Flair lost to Macho Man and Mr. Perfect. And also, we were treated to a main event of Shawn Michaels versus Bret Hart. I believe, and I want some people to do some fact-checking on this, I believe that was Shawn Michaels' first televised main event for the WWF title in 1992 at Survivor Series against Bret Hart. I was there. Think about it. If that was Shawn's first main event run, at least on a major show, main event match, went on last, I was there. Why? Because I'm King Virtue. So that's my problem with Survivor Series. John Cena on SmackDown, Triple H on Raw. Some people are going to say, oh, it was needed, it was needed, it was needed. Look, you are never going to get the new generation, the current and the next generation over is like your Austins and your Rocks. If you keep bringing back the past and plugging them in there, stealing thunder. You know, Vince McMahon is scared. He's scared. He's scared to do anything different that the fans want. So he keeps doing what he wants. And to me, I just don't agree with that.
Any questions? Brandon King. I can see Adam Cole as WWE champ in 2 years. I can't. Now, because there's the two brands, possibly. Adam Cole is, he's like Finn Balor. I don't know. I just don't, when I see those type of guys against the Brock Lesnar, against the Roman Reigns, I'm just not buying it. You know, here's the thing. Look at New Japan. Sometimes you don't even need to be in the IWGP heavyweight division. That Intercontinental title over there is like almost just as high as their main title. WWE needs to do that. So maybe the wrestlers like AJ, Finn, Adam Cole, they can compete for that title, and it still means a lot, the whole world, you know. And then you can have your heavyweights like your Brocks and your Reigns, so, you know, Vince McMahon can sell toys at Kmart and Walmart. But they just don't do it right. I mean, even when they make a new belt, like the United Kingdom Championship, yeah, sure, Pete Dunne's defending it at shows over there, but, like, we talked about it on the NXT preview video. He's not – him and Gargano, that match isn't even going to be on the NXT event. It's just going to be for people in attendance in Houston. Like, it's just – come on. I mean, really. What are we kidding? I see Daniel said Jason Jordan will cost Team Raw at Survivor Series. You know, and it's setting up that way. I mean, there's nowhere else they can go. Either Jason Jordan is completely gone until they repackage him in a tag team, or he turns heel. You know, if he ends up helping them win and cries with his dad and celebrating, that would – all right, you brought me on to something here, Daniel. Let's pretend like Team Raw wins. We'll win, okay? And Jason Jordan actually helps Kurt Angle is a sole survivor. I don't know how it would happen, but just pretend. And everybody's like, yeah, he ended up getting his moment with his dad. You know, Team Raw wins, you know, kumbaya, kumbaya. And then just before Survivor Series goes off the air, Jason Jordan snaps and he does something to Angle. There you go. There you go. Just brilliant, brilliant. I'm going to give kudos to Daniel on that one. Daniel Mullinax. Sounds like a car dealership. You selling Ford Mustangs? You know, that's really all I wanted to talk about. If anybody brings up another question about wrestling, I will talk about it, but let me cover my video game stuff like I do. So my games of the week. So I'm going to show these here. You know, it's always my bad lighting here, reflecting off of this. These are also on PlayStation 4. You have Batman, Arkham Knight, Batman, Return to Arkham. It's Batman month, by the way, on Great Lakes Video Game Facebook page. These stealth games, everybody knows Arkham Asylum, Arkham City, Arkham Origins. These just continue that saga. Very, very good games. I would rather play games like this because I'm, you know, invested with the comics and DC and the movies, and it's just all in all, you know, then Grand Theft Auto. So go ahead, dislike, thumbs down. But these are awesome. And I even like those Telltale Batman games, although they're really not games. They're just like kind of playing through the story. And then finally, I won't mention the Tim Burton Batman movies because everyone knows those are my favorite. But let's go to the Nolan ones. I think the best one of the three wasn't Dark Knight. I think Dark Knight was highly overrated because of Heath Ledger's great performance. But Batman Begins. This, to me, is one of the best Batman movies there is, and I'm going to tell you why. Because for the first time, we really got into Bruce Wayne as the character, not Batman. And I'm going to tell you what. I think the best Batman, in my opinion, was Michael Keaton. But I'm going to go out on a limb. And it definitely wasn't Ben Affleck. It definitely wasn't Val Kilmer. It definitely wasn't George Clooney. But Christian Bale. See how I did that? I forgot his name. And I segued my way right to it. But honestly, Christian Bale played a heck of a Bruce Wayne. And maybe it's some of that American Psycho that I, you know, vibe I got in his style of Bruce Wayne. Maybe that's why I liked it so much. But hopefully someone would agree with me on that, that Batman Begins is a hell of a movie. Go watch it this month because it's Batman month. Play a Batman video game. But with that said, that's going to conclude King Virtue's Rage. Thank you for joining. Mr. Brandon King, don't forget your game will be mailed to you that you won for your Xbox One Rhyme. And you even get a cloth map. Stay tuned to NoDQ.com for breaking news from Aaron Rift. Pop panel videos with David Payne, Aaron Rift, myself, and a guest. NoDQ panel videos with Jeff Meacham, Aaron Rift, myself, and a guest. All kinds of other content put up on NoDQ.com, such as Kayfabe Candy Ass writing columns, Virtue's Rage writing columns, Jay's Ways, all kinds of great content. And, of course, Aaron keeps you up with the news. Go to ProWrestlingTees.com, search NoDQ. Almost everybody has a T-shirt. Make sure you buy the Virtue's Rage one. And I know that there's 5% off code now. Aaron will smarten you up to that. Black Friday is going to be a better sale, but go, support, support, support. You can follow me on Twitter at NoDQ_Virtue. You know you can always interact with me on Twitter, even Facebook to a point. If you liked King Virtue, this is where I get serious for a minute. Please let me know. If you think King Virtue should step into a wrestling ring, maybe UXWA, and try to take over, let me know. If you live within driving distance of Cleveland area, such as Detroit, Erie, Pittsburgh, Cincinnati, Columbus, West Virginia, Indiana, stay tuned because we have some shows coming up in 2018, and I will be involved. And that alone should sell 50 tickets. And you know what? If you reach out to me to get a ticket for UXWA shows, it's $15 at the door, but you can get them from me for $10, and I might even buy a lucky fan or two a free ticket. So why not? Indie wrestling. Indie wrestling with people that actually want to entertain fans and not just put on matches and go through the motions. That's what it's all about. But Eric Bischoff, thumbs down. Hit the road, Jack. Survivor Series, I'm on the fence. John Cena does not need to be in there. Let's bring Big Vito back to NoDQ.com panel videos. And you know all my video game stuff. That's it. Thank you for watching.